Hi, I'm Malik Thompson, an aerospace materials engineer at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center. And here we're celebrating National Engineers Week and Black History Month. So it started in seventh grade, and at the time we were doing like a career event where they sent us home and told us to plan out our whole lives, everything from where we might live to the job we might have. And at the time, I thought I wanted to be a paleontologist. And then when I got into the details, I was like, maybe that's not quite for me. So it was actually one of my parents that suggested that I start looking, based on my experience and love for science fiction, into something to do with space. And that's when I decided that I wanted to be an engineer to help be a part of the space game. From day to day, it feels like it changes sometimes because I work a lot of different programs and projects. I'm always hungry for the next thing over the horizon. But for the most part, as an aerospace materials engineer, I work with the planning and production of different spacecraft and launch vehicles in order to get them into space and make sure that they're space worthy. So for Artemis and for the Commercial Crew Program, I'm primarily focused on launch vehicles. And in my case, the thermal protection systems that go into protecting both the propellants as well as the structures that they're made of. So it goes without saying that there's a lot of challenges in the work that we do. Space is difficult. President Kennedy said it in the 60s and we're living it now. But that's not where it ends, because there are a lot of us that are passionate about what we do. So those challenges become that much smaller because of it. And then so far as the rewards go, I think a lot about how my little brother and sister, they have always lived in a world where people have been living and working in space. And now I get to be a part of what the next generation will experience so far as having people actively living and working on the moon permanently. And that makes it that much more worthwhile. It's important because NASA, as a government agency, should resemble the country that it represents and ensure that we all have a seat at the table. And diversity and inclusion are important, but they're often conflated with simply just having people in a room. And it goes beyond that, because Malcolm X said that just because a person is sitting at the table, it doesn't make them a diner. And we have to be able to eat from that plate too. And NASA does an amazing job. We do a great job of making sure that people are included, but then also making sure that they're a part of the team and being able to contribute in the best way that they can. And it's important too for the future that we gather people with disparate backgrounds and ideas to be able to get us to that common goal, because space isn't easy and we need everybody on deck. It's a twofold answer really, because at the beginning of it, it's Nichelle Nichols who played Lieutenant Uhura in the Star Trek TV series. And at that point, there hadn't been very many African-American women who starred in TV shows that weren't in subservient roles. She was an active member of the crew that contributed a lot of technical knowledge and experience, and they valued her for it, much like I do now at NASA. And then because of that work, she was invited to Johnson Space Center to be able to see the everyday work at NASA. And when she saw that, she realized that there weren't very many people of color, people that looked like her, that were around. And so she decided to do something about it. And when she did, she traveled the country for months in order to recruit women and people of color to apply to be astronauts. And the class that followed, because of her work, was the most diverse that had happened at that time. So that class included Ronald McNair, an African-American man from small town South Carolina, just like myself. And he grew up 1 hour away from the dirt road that I grew up in. So that showed me, above all else, that I could do it too, and I could be a part of NASA. It's interesting, I actually just recently did an outreach event with high school students, and I was telling them this very same thing, wherein it's a matter of always persevere. No matter how hard things get, no matter how difficult things may seem, you're never alone. The most important part about STEM is peer review and being on a team. So you're never really alone, and you're never really up against the whole hurdle by yourself. That you always have people to call on, whether they're professors in school or coworkers and team members in the workplace. In the workplace, it's important to keep in mind that you're not ever above anything and you're not below anything. That there's work that at one point may seem like, you know, you're not doing the most that you feel like you can, but you never know what might come in handy later on. And by the same token, you yourself have something very significant to contribute that only you can contribute. So you owe it to yourself and to everyone that you're working with to be able to contribute that thing. And always speak up and do your best.